What if your room could dance to the beat of your favorite song? Hey guys, in this video I'll show you how to make a simple yet powerful music reactive LED circuit using BC547 transistors. Stay tuned to the second part of this video where I'll explain how this circuit works. Here are all the components you need to set up this circuit. 9 jumper wires, 5 LEDs, 6 BC547 transistors, 1 condenser microphone, 1 0.1 microfarad ceramic capacitor, 2 10,000 ohm resistors, 1 1 million ohm resistor, 5 220 ohm resistors, 1 9 volt battery, 1 9 volt battery buckle connector, a breadboard to connect everything together. The BC547 is an NPN bipolar junction transistor used in electronic circuits for switching and amplification. It has 3 terminals: collector, base, and emitter. When you send a small current into the base, it allows a much larger current to flow from the collector to the emitter. That's how it can control or amplify things like music signals to flash LEDs. Let's set up the circuit step by step. Begin by inserting the BC547 transistor on the breadboard. The collector is positioned on the left side. Refer to the later circuit diagram if you have questions about the circuit connections. Insert a 0.1 microfarad ceramic capacitor into the base of the transistor and one row above it. Insert a jumper wire in the same row as the capacitor and a few rows above it. Insert a jumper wire to connect the gap. Insert a jumper wire to connect the left side of the breadboard to the negative rail. Note the position of the jumper wire. It is one row below the other jumper wire. Insert the condenser microphone in the same rows as the jumper wires. The terminal with the green stripes is connected to a jumper wire that leads to the negative rail. Insert a jumper wire in the same row as the collector of the transistor and a few rows below it. Insert a jumper wire in the same row as the transistor's emitter and the negative rail. Bend the ends of a 10,000 ohm resistor. Insert the 10,000 ohm resistor into the same row as the microphone and the positive rail. Bend the ends of a 10,000 ohm resistor. Insert the 10,000 ohm resistor into the same row as the transistor's collector and the positive rail. Bend the ends of a 1 million ohm resistor. Insert the 1 million ohm resistor into the same row as the transistor's base and the positive rail. Insert the transistor's base in the same row as the jumper wire. Insert the red LED in the same row as the transistor's collector and the positive rail. The anode is in the positive rail. Bend the ends of a 220 ohm resistor. Insert the 220 ohm resistor into the same row as the transistor's emitter and the negative rail. Insert a jumper wire in the same row as the transistor's base and a few rows below it. The next few steps will repeat. Insert the transistor's base in the same row as the jumper wire. Insert the green LED in the same row as the transistor's collector and the positive rail. The anode is in the positive rail. bend the ends of a 220 ohm resistor. Insert the 220 ohm resistor into the same row as the transistor's emitter and the negative rail. Insert a jumper wire in the same row as the transistor's base and a few rows below it. Attach the buckle connector to the 9-volt battery. It's time to connect the power supply. Insert the positive lead to the positive rail. Insert the negative lead to the negative rail. We have successfully completed the circuit. When there's a beat or a sound spike, the transistor conducts and the LED flashes. Let's dive into the circuit and break it down step by step. This music reactive or rhythm LED circuit uses a BC547 transistor-based design to make LEDs flash in sync with music or audio beats. The circuit begins with an audio input, which is the microphone. This audio signal first passes through a 10,000 ohm resistor and a 100 nanofarad capacitor. The resistor limits the current, while the capacitor blocks DC components and allows only the AC audio signal to pass through. A 1 million ohm resistor connected to the base of the first BC547 transistor acts as a biasing resistor, making the transistor more sensitive to the microphone. The first BC547 transistor serves as a preamplifier. Its base receives the filtered audio signal, the emitter is connected to ground, and the collector is connected to the 9-volt battery through a 10,000 ohm resistor. As music plays, the varying voltage of the signal causes the transistor to switch on and off rapidly. This creates small current pulses that mimic the rhythm and volume of the music. These pulses are then passed down a chain of 5 more BC547 transistors, each controlling an LED. Every transistor has a 220 ohm resistor in series with an LED connected to its collector. When the signal from the preamplifier is strong enough, it turns these transistors on one by one, depending on the amplitude of the signal. As each transistor switches on, it allows current to flow through its respective LED, causing it to light up. The result is a set of LEDs that flash in dynamic patterns, responding directly to the beat and intensity of the audio. The overall effect is a simple but effective music reactive light system. This circuit doesn't require microcontrollers or complex programming. It uses basic electronic components to detect audio signals and translate them into visual feedback. I hope this video has shown you how to make a music reactive LED with BC547 transistor. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up. Consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.